okay to bend your legs. It's your great flexibility. Okay. Okay. Bend over, grab hold of your toes. Bend your knees as much as you need to grab your toes. Okay. Because what you want to do now is keep your feet and fingers where they are. You want to drop slowly into a squat. Okay. Drop slowly into a squat. Get your elbows inside your knees. Push your knees out. Lift your chest up. Okay. Heels on the floor. Okay. And now come up to straight.
We've got to think, I mean, people talk about
about increasing flexibility. What you're trying to overcome is your body's tendency to tighten up. If you think about it, a muscle has to, in a certain way, originate from set points. So every team should be as flexible as each other. The problem is cut as well. Against the stretch really well, because all muscles work on an anti-muscle basis. If one muscle has the time to move through a squat, then your quads are moving anti-muscle. So one contracts and one stretches. So if you contract at the point of the stretch, like in the bottom of the squat or the bottom of the leg, like this, then not only are you working the muscle, and it should be, okay, because it's creating flexibility in that movement. I'm not a fan. You get a momentary, look, I'm a bit more flexible. But the thing is, you never have to be flexible, static. Okay, you always have to be moving sport, flexible, dynamic, which is very, very difficult. So if you look at people who are naturally, or if you look at people who have got great flexibility, gymnastics, dancers of all sorts,
Yeah, we usually keep the cameras just over there.
No, I mean, so yeah, like I said, any questions? I'm not saying too much there, so you're not saying it's an email.
Okay, now, put the bar back on.
Yeah. Well done. Okay, we'll use this little spot for our flank.